pandemic has aggravated communication issues within some families and couples. That's why psychologist Patricia Flor recommends using this time of loosened restrictions to think about how to restore relationships. I think the main pillar to work on is spending quality time together and returning to those gestures of affection and care, to return to thinking about admiration in a couple, to once more set goals and start dreaming of futures for our relationships. Patricia Flor says that the pandemic has led to an increased number of cases of anxiety, stress, and depression in both adults and adolescents. In order to prevent these issues, I think it's essential to have clear norms and limits. In other words, I have to understand what my role is at home, within my family, and we have to understand that there are limits and that there are consequences when those limits are exceeded. This applies to families and couples. Experts at the MoMA Family Care Center explain how to address one of the most difficult aspects of restoring relationships, which is speaking. Maria Hernandez says it's important to communicate one's feelings without resentment.
Habla con sinceridad con esa persona, dile.
Speak sincerely with that person. Tell them how their actions made you feel. Open up to that person, but don't generalize or be dismissive. Knowing when and how to express things is an art, but even the popes recommend working on it. Pope Francis, for example, says it's better to speak than to stay silent and slowly grow apart. It's what he calls the Cold War. Maria Hernandez explains that communicating requires understanding one's own feelings. It's a difficult skill to acquire, but she recommends meditating because it helps control one's mood.